So Kitze, so there are so many frameworks and libraries happening, you know, appearing all the time.
It's a crazy world.
Yeah. The front end world. In the JavaScript, the front end world. And it's very hard to know, like, should I jump into this new framework with this library? Should I start learning it?
Yeah.
How should we do?
People have the wrong problems. People are jumping to this, like, they're following the cycle of, like, following the latest and greatest because they're not focusing on the right things. So I think that front-end developers, like, right now are super spoiled, so they have a lot of free time. Every office has, like, a ping-pong table and a PlayStation and this and that, so we have a lot of free time to, like, procrastinate and think and basically, like, hey, there's a new library, I want this one, and I want to learn that one, and I need that one. So I think that comes from a point where users are not, where developers are not focused on the right things. So if you're not focused on the users that you're making your app for, and if you're not focused on, like, other more important things, then you're focusing on following the crazy world of JavaScript and what's going on. So at first, I think it's a problem of focus, but then it's a problem of FOMO. So everyone has this, like, fear of missing out. And right now I'm doing this interview and I'm thinking, oh my God, someone on Twitter is posting, like, this amazing stuff about front-end web development and so on. And I'm not there to read it, and later it's not going to be there. So I think we live in constant fear that we're missing out on knowledge and cool libraries that can solve our problems. So,
but if you look back, like, technology has changed so many times.
Exactly. Yeah.
That you need to follow anyway.
You need to follow, but the trick is, when do you make the jumping point? So you need to ask yourself a couple of important questions. Like, is now the right time? Usually it's not, but people like to lie to themselves and they're like, yeah, now is the right time to jump to GraphQL. You're in the middle of the sprint, everything is on fire, but three developers decide and they're like, now we should migrate to Apollo. So you should figure out how easy is the transition. Some transitions are super easy, like when you're migrating, let's say, a CSS in JS library, when you're moving to Emotion, to style components, or something with a similar API. It doesn't matter at the end of the day. You're going to migrate it in like 15 minutes. But when you're migrating from REST to Apollo or from Angular to React, you really need to sit down and be like, is now the right time? Do we have the budget? Do we have the engineering capacity and so on? Should we make the jumping point? And usually we make the jump out of boredom, not that we actually need the other thing and not that it's actually going to solve our problem. So what I see is, there was a real story about a shopping addict, like a real life shopping addict, and he was using, like, a credit card all the time to buy things. And how he cured that addiction, and he's just put the credit card in the freezer. So anytime he wanted to buy something, he's out and he wants to buy a TV or something, he would just have to sleep on the decision, and he would have to go home, unfreeze the credit card, and the next day to visit the store and actually pay with the credit card. And you can guess, like, in most of the scenarios, he never went back to buy it. So that worked for, like, someone in real life. Development, it is real life. But I think developers should adopt this technique of sleeping on decision. Like, not everything is an abstraction. Not everything needs to be abstracted in a library. Not everything is a library. You don't need to install that library right away. I think we should sleep on this decision and actually evaluate if we actually need it, if it's going to make things more complex, or is it going to make them simpler. Because I think all of these abstractions, like when you see a cool framework, library, and so on, you should think of it that it's just another abstraction. So at first it may look like, oh, this is a solution to my problem, but then it can be a cause of 1,000 new problems for you. So before
unknown ones, then that's why you don't care about it.
Unknown ones, yeah. When you look at the readme, you're like, oh my God, this is so pretty, I need this in my life. And then you're like, oh my God, this had like 1,000 other problems, and now I'm screwed, I have to reverse back, it wasn't an abstraction. So all the time we're losing time of this cycle. Even if it's not adopting a library, even if it is just writing your own abstraction, we're losing time, like, oh, this is an abstraction. Then, like, 5 days later, this wasn't an abstraction. I abstracted it too early. Now I need to revert back. So we're just losing time in that cycle of, like, abstracting, like, taking a library. No, I don't need the library. And so on.
But yourself, like, when you hear about a new technology, new trick, or new framework,
yeah,
do you learn about it, like, enough to understand what is it, and then you say, okay, I'm going to get back to this?
So it's a bit hypocritical, because if you follow me on Twitter, I'm the guy who's usually jumping on all of these new things, but you should get the story behind the person, because I'm doing workshops, I'm working with different teams and so on. It's a benefit for me if I know everything that's going on. But as you said, I'm not doing a deep dive into some topics, but I keep them, like, in the back of my head. So let's say I was that person. Like, I was the person when you're starting as a developer, you want to know everything. You want to be the smartest one, right? So you see an article on Medium about SVGs and you're like, now is the time. I'm going to become an expert on SVGs. So you sit down, you read, you go through the tutorial. And then a couple of months later, like, you forget about everything. You forget about the syntax. Like, even if you're working with React, after a while, if you don't work with it, you're going to forget some syntax. So what's the point of doing a deep dive into a technology if then you forget what was going on? So I'm not saying that developers should just be lazy and just sleep. And if you know a technology, I'm good and I don't need to learn everything else. You should be curious. You should read articles and like follow Twitter and Reddit and what's going on. But don't do deep dives into certain technologies just for the sake of, you know, I want to be an expert in everything. Keep them in the back of your mind. Know what's going on. Like, know there is an alternative to the problem that you're having right now.
So this technology might solve 1, 2, 3, exactly. But I need to dig more into
it. Yeah, but we might adopt it later. Like, I knew about React for a year before I had adopted it. I knew about GraphQL for a year before I adopted it in my projects. I'm like, it's great there is a solution for my problem, but I need to find like the sweet spot when we're migrating between projects, or it's the right time to actually implement this new framework or library or whatever it is.
So it works for me. Cool. Yeah.